Hey folks, welcome back to another Yonder Mountain Adventure. Welcome back to the channel. We're in for an absolute treat today. I'm going to be joined by a good mate of mine, in fact my best mate, Mountain Mick. It's the first time he's been on the channel. We're in for an absolute blinder. We're in for a wild camp, and I'm testing out some new kit as well. The kind folks at NIGHTCAT have kindly sent us an ultra-light one-man trekking pole tent. I know I've had a bit of a look at it, and it looks like an epic bit of kit. So I'm going to put it through its tests tonight and see how it fares. I'm going to really put it through its paces. The forecast was very good, but in actual fact, I'm talking to you from inside the car because it's blowing an absolute hoolie out there. So true to form, the weather forecast is absolutely not what it actually is. So I think this is going to be a really good test for the tent. We're in a nice spot here. You might be able to see just here. We're in the heart of Northumberland. And we've got some nice food to cook. We're going to have a big roaring fire. We'll put this tent through its tests as well. So stay tuned, folks. We're in for an absolute treat. Difference the weight of this pack with the new NIGHTCAT tent. It's less than half the weight of my others, and it packs down so small I've got more room for luxuries like beer. There's Mountain Mick. Hey, we've got a little Trevor with him as well. We've got plenty of supplies. Mick's doing a car camp tonight. It depends on what mood is, what we call him. But he's an action figure, is Travis. Right, I'll just swing you around so you can see. Sun poking through the trees there, just above Mountain Mick. This is my spot. What do you think, Mick? Right folks, first things first, look at the size of that. It'll be bungle hand. It's absolutely tiny. And you know what? You can actually probably pack it down that little bit further as well, maybe. It's absolutely tiny. It weighs 942 grams. And with it you get the inner, you get the fly sheet, you get your pegs, which are the same as my nature height ones, little aluminium pegs, which are absolutely spot on. It's got 5,000 static head unit waterproofing on the fly, and it's got an 8,000 static head unit bathtub. So this, for this little package like that, it's going to be absolutely epic. Spot on. Big difference on the pack size, the weight of my backpack. Loads of room for other stuff as well, so spot on. Right, let's get it going. So inside the bag, folks, you've got your peg bag. These are the little titanium pegs. They're very, very lightweight, but they're actually very, very strong. You get probably 10 of them. There's a load of paracord and also some repair patches. It would have been nice if they were the same color as the tent, but if there's any rips or tears that you get on it, that'll definitely do the business. All of that comes with it. So folks, as you can see, you just peg out from the corner of the
bathtub all the way out into the pegs. As you can see there, there's a little notch here as well. So you do that on all four corners first, as you can see. And that's it, kind of just put into place. I've got it this way on because the wind is coming in this way. So I've got the back towards the wind. So folks, once it's all pegged out, good lad Trevor, you just get a hold of these and you just tension it up. Poles, and as you can see, that's tautening that whole side up. Now that can have a good bit of tension on there, as you can see. Do that on all four sides. And that's got a pretty taut pitch. Quite happy with that. We'll just show you this on the front. This is the front door. As you can see, it's got the ram's horn kind of affair here. And what you do is you unclasp the door from there. I haven't really come across that before, but it certainly seems strong. It's made with good material, that's for sure. The other thing that I would say as well, now this is the door. The top part here is reinforced up here for the trekking pole. When that goes in, that is reinforced. And this, which is the storm flap, move to the other side here, that is very, very strong material. And you've also got some good, very strong Velcro here as well, which would be very, very good. And some other Velcro up the top. Looks really good. You know, one of the other things everybody else with the tent seems to be complaining about is the logo. Usually it's absolutely massive. Now, I don't know whether this is a newer version, maybe, or whatever, but that's nice and discreet, as you can see. Nightcat. So what I've done here, folks, is I've put a trekking pole in and I've got a guy wrapped around it and pegged down for one very good reason, and that is on the actual back of the tent. It lifts this up here, which will actually give us more internal space. I'll bring you inside when I get there. Right, well, the first thing that I notice, you got a very big vestibule there. It's quite deep, it goes down the half length of the tent, so that's going to be ideal for your gear. And it does look pretty spacious in here as well. I just need to adjust it so there's a little bit less sag, but otherwise that doesn't look too bad. Nice to see the reinforcements in all of the corners there as well. And I can tell the material itself is actually very, very strong. So far so good. That hasn't taken too long. That's the first time I've really pitched it. I just need to do a couple of little minor adjustments just so there's less sag inside, but otherwise that looks pretty good. Right, time to get my gear in. Absolutely loads of room in there. That vestibule's fantastic. Got all the gear. And inside, I've got my mat, I've got the UL80 technology, and I've got my Leviathan. I've got two pillars. You can see there's space at the back there. That's my Vango 65 litre bag. And also room down at the other side for clothes or whatever. There's actually loads of space down the other side. For a one-man tent, that's absolutely ideal. There's plenty of room there for sure. Well, I probably haven't got it pitched out perfectly because this is the first time. It needs a little bit of tinkering on, but I'm 6 foot and you know, I'm sat up here and I've got headroom as well. There's actually quite a bit of space, to be honest. Now, it is more snug than the other two tents, but they're two-man tents. This is a one-man tent, and considering the weight benefits of it, it does actually afford quite a lot of space as well. There's more than enough room for me to get stretched out in here, like I say, 6 foot, and there's plenty of room. And by the time I get the tinkering on done and get it just tight, it's going to tighten up some of the sag which is here, but in actual fact there's not much at all. But what I can tell you straight away is, even in quite strong wind here at the minute, it's about 17 mile an hour wind, this is holding up. It didn't take too much putting up and it seems to be bearing up quite well. The build quality is genuinely good. I'm pleased with it so far. So I'm gonna get a bit of a cuppa on the go. Mick's gone back down to the car there to get some of his gear. Mick's doing a car camp tonight. So he's just gone to sort some of his gear out, and then he's gonna come back up. We're gonna get the fire area sorted out, and get a couple of drinks poured, I think, and try and enjoy the rest of the afternoon. We've got a, hopefully in for a good sunset here tonight as well. And I'll just show you around camp so you've got a better idea. I'll get some nice shots of the tent so you can kind of see exactly what we're talking about. Just been sitting chilling out and watching the sun go down. I've just done a motion lapse there, but in the meantime, me and Mountain Mick have just been mix on the vodka coke, mate.
Yeah, improvised Buxton cup.
Makes it taste better. A bit of bushcrafting going on there, mate. He's multi-skilled, this Mountain Mick, you know, don't you, mate? Mm-hmm. Very much. And little Trevor, or Basil.
His real name's Travis.
We never get to call him. Everyone calls him Trevor. He gets called Trevor, he's all terrain, he's been all over the place. But we're concerned a little bit about adders. Basically, Mick says
he packs a punch.
He packs a punch, and actually, it's probably more the adders that need to be scared.
other than Basil.
Probably eat one.
Because he's full scale, he really is. He's been on some adventures with us, mate, hasn't he? It's been a magic sunset, just sitting having a couple of drinks.
Really nice.
Really, it's a nice spot. This is the first time up here, mate.
Yeah, just what the doctor ordered.
A bit of prescription nature, and Trevor's absolutely loving it. Even the dogs like it as much as we do. Absolutely champion, really good. So we're gonna get some. We're gonna wait until the sun dips down, mate, and then we've got some canny bait, haven't we, for the night?
Well, I've got a rump steak and a sirloin steak.
Have you? Have you?
Get in. I've got two rump steaks and some asparagus.
Hey, we're gone.
So that'll be all right. We've got the fireplace already set up, and. Mick's got his CTL like Huckleberry Finn pitched up against the tree, just watching what's going on here.
Lovely.
And it's just absolutely magic. Like Mick says, it's just what the doctor ordered. Well, that's the fire up and running. That's really kicking off some heat now, and I must admit, now that the sun's gone down, the temperature has definitely dropped as well. You can really feel a difference. The fire's absolutely roaring, absolutely champion. You know what, there's loads of deadfall here as well. We have brought quite a few logs, and obviously we're going to tidy this place up. There'll be absolutely zero trace of us being here. But isn't it mental, coming out into wild places like this? My mate Mick was over there, he says, "Oh, did you whistle there?" I says, no. Anyway, as we were just having a drink there watching the sunset, this lady came walking over here with a brown chocolate Labrador and a pink hat. And I thought to myself, that can only be one person, that, and sure enough it was. Em's Adventure. Nice to meet you, Em's. What an absolute belter. That was total class, that. Like, isn't it mad? You know, we've been speaking to each other on Instagram and on YouTube comments and watching my videos and stuff. I feel like I already know you. Absolutely mental. Nice to meet you. We'll definitely get a camp sorted out sometime soon, Ems, without a doubt. Yeah, well, we're gonna have a couple more cans. We've got Mountain Mick over here. He's just finishing off another vodka. But little Trevor's down there as well. And we're just gonna soak up the rest of this sunset. We've got some nice colours coming over here. Actually, the wind has died down a little bit now as well, which is absolutely class. So I will crack open another tin. Thank you. absolutely unbelievable. I've had two rump steaks and some asparagus. Mountain Mick, he's just tucking into his ribeye over there at the minute with a little bit of peppercorn sauce. Trevor's had his supper as well, and we're just going to soak up a little bit of the last embers from the fire here and watch the moon rise. It's a little bit eerie tonight, and then I'm going to get myself tucked up back in the Nightcat. Definitely Mick's going to head back and retire to the car. Good luck on his return journey to the car, because it's going to take a good 5 minute walk. And he's away with a mixer, so good luck to Mick. But anyway, I'll bring you back when I'm in the tent. Right, folks, that's me in the bed. Mountain Mick's away back to the car. The steaks were absolutely tremendous. The fire was amazing. It's been a really good night. The temperature has really dropped now. There's actually a bit of frost outside as well. I've just been back to the car to get some supplies before crawling into bed here. And there's a bit of frost. The car said it was 7 degrees, but I'm guessing it's lower than that. It feels lower than that. Anyway, I'm tucked up in the Nightcat here. Really comfy. There's actually plenty of space. I've got my backpack tucked in next to us here. I'm full stretch here. And as much as it's been windy and it's been cold, this has withstood everything that tonight's thrown at it. I'm genuinely pretty pleased with it. I'm just looking at some of the seams here on the inside as well. Everything's seam sealed. And this is a robust bit of kit. I can see how if you're doing long multi-day treks and you need something mega lightweight, this is going to do the business for you. So I'm going to sign off now, folks. Good night, God bless. We'll see you in the morning. And I'm going to cook up some bacon sandwiches for me and Mountain Mick. See what time he rises. And we'll see you in the morning. Good night. Morning, folks. Well, another good night's sleep there in the old Nightcat, one man trekking tent, cracking bit of kit. I really enjoyed that. Actually, there was a lot more room than probably what I first anticipated. It got windy through the night as well, but it looks absolutely fine. I've just checked all the pegs, everything's still in place, everything looks to be absolutely mint, and we've been blessed with a beautiful sunrise this morning. Hopefully see the colours just coming up over the background there, and just looking down over beautiful Northumberland. Absolutely stunning. Just had a message from Mountain Mick. He's just stirring there. I think his tummy's rumbling, wants his bacon sandwich, and so do I. So we'll get that on the go. But definitely first impressions. I think that tent's been put through its test last night, through the night. You know, I've slept in it. Very, very comfortable, very well made. Good value. I'll put a link in the description for you. For the tent as well. I know I've been given the tent by Nightcat, but I'm not just going to say it's good if it's not. If it was crap, I would tell you it was crap. But it's actually, I'm really genuinely impressed with it. It's a good, solid bit of kit. And I think definitely on, you know, multi-day hikes, that's really going to come in on its own. Good bit of kit. Really good bit of kit. Right, I'm going to soak up a little bit of this light. Wait for Mountain Mick to arrive. He's just... Well, actually, I can see the light over there at the car. We'll get this bacon sandwich on the go. Well, folks, that's it for another Yonder Mountain adventure. breakfast cooked. Tremendous bacon sandwich. There's no better than cooking outdoors, is there? Absolutely tremendous. We've got a beautiful sunrise kicking off just here now as well. So we're just going to soak up the last half an hour of this strike camp and then have a slow drive home, get things packed away. So until the next time, folks, just remember the importance of getting out into somewhere like this and doing these types of things. Forget about Facebook and the news and the radio and newspapers. Get out and soak up a bit of prescription nature. So until next time, folks, it's a goodbye from me, it's a goodbye from Trevor, and it's a goodbye from Mountain Mick. See you on the next one. Absolutely tremendous.